get through one color today. Let's see how far we get. So let me know what you guys think. The controls are very simple. You press the space bar. Some of the controls change a little bit later, and some of the other ones are similar to those. Question for you, Zephyr. Can you tell me the sounds and soundtrack? Tell me how that sounds now. Can you hear me speaking? Yeah? Awesome. Thank you. I'm going to monitor this stream, the stream's audio from now on. As I mentioned, I'm a bit sick, so, you know, little details are just kind of flying out the window today. one of the messages I like here is that anger is kind of a surging emotion, that it can be a crushing one while it's a heavy burden to carry. The first time I played this, I got so anxious for her when she was being blown over by the gusts of wind. That is sort of also a very interesting commentary on intense emotion by turning yourself to stone and could also be a commentary on the force of will. Hi, Dubstep Paladin. No, I agree, Zephyr. It is a really beautiful game. I can bring these spells when I jump at them. That's always struck me as a very whimsical kind of touch. I first played this game when I was going through a very difficult. It really spoke to my own experience of recovery, and I feel like it could do that for a lot of people, and probably already has. But this idea that you have to go deeper to come back up, for me, that's very much how it works. What I do here. That's half the fun, right? What I always think when that happens. So, the world of Gris is intended to represent a person's internal landscape. And one of the things I like best about it is you get all these little helpful things that allow you to move forward. I really like to think about the idea that all the tools you need to recover from something that's happened to you are already inside you. Just have press the right button, cross the right bridge. Definitely a precision platformer, but not like Celeste precision platformer. I love Celeste. It's such a hard game, but it's so good. So, you know, if you really love intense precision platformers, you should absolutely play Celeste. This is more forgiving. Get it, I promise. Very good. Yes, there we go. Thanks, Seth Root. Oh, hey, Commander Root. Good to see you again. So I would definitely love everyone's thoughts on the game so far. Have you played it? Have you not? Do you want to? Just what kind of experience does it seem like to you, or was it for you, if you played it? I personally felt like this was a very important game for me to play, just for personal reasons, but because Queenship makes games about mental health, so it's obviously a good idea for us to study games that have addressed any of these kinds of issues successfully before now. I found it, as a game developer, I found it very inspiring. It would be fair to say I want to make Gris, but I want to make games I said that for like a year, Zephyr, before I finally bought it. I was just like, oh, it looks so good, but I'm like, for a while I really just couldn't justify the expense. As weird as that sounds, very glad that I bought it now. It's really helped me a lot. getting there. Sometimes you gotta go back to go forward. Even if it's just to remind you to breathe. Puzzle I just could not work out of my own. I felt very stupid afterwards. It was one of those puzzles that you want to overthink but doesn't require overthinking at all. After you get it, it seems obvious. Even though it tried that, Zephyr. Like, there's a different trick to it, I think. I just don't really know what it is. Mm-hmm. In case this is not super obvious, I like puzzles, but they are not super my forte. To play more Sudoku or something. Glamorous mermaid. Thanks for joining us this evening. The first time I played this game, this particular puzzle took me forever. Ta-da! Sorry for all the sniffling, as I mentioned earlier. I'm a little sick today. I'm not a dual screen today, so feel free to leave comments and questions. I have been periodically checking the chat. that I will warn you guys, if you do decide to play this game, it is not a super long play, but the emotional impact is tremendous. There are parts of it that are difficult. If you have even like half a soul, you probably won't get through it without crying at least once. But it's not a bad kind, if that makes sense. About through one color, getting into green from red. So I'll probably hang out with you guys for another 30-40 minutes or so. Usually we stream for a couple of hours, but I'm very tired today. I hope you'll forgive me for that. But I also don't want to spoil like a big chunk of the game for you guys if you decide to play it, because like I said, it's not very long. On a somewhat lighter note, I really love the character design of Gris. I think she's just beautiful. She could be any one of my friends. I will probably cosplay her at some point, not least because my hair is mostly the same color as hers, just more green. All these cute little things you run into in the woods. There's an especially adorable thing that happens later, but I'm not gonna spoil it. There are a couple of things I wanted to mention because, you know, shameless self-promotion and all that. If you haven't played Queenship's first release, Open Spaces, it is available on itch.io. It is a visual novel of anxiety and agoraphobia. So if you or someone you know has either of those disorders, we hope it'll be a helpful and informative game for you to play. We are currently working on a 3D adventure game called House of Echoes that is about the experience of hallucinations, which are much more common than most people suppose. So we're hoping to have that out by the end of the year. We are currently running an Indiegogo campaign for that. So check out our Facebook and Twitter, and even if you can't pledge, just encourage your friends, family, etc. to do so. because we could really use your help in finishing it. I feel like it's a really important game. I'll give you guys sort of a sneak peek of what we're going to be working on after that. We're going to be working on a game called The Shadow Cross, and that is about the experience of depression, which affects millions of people around the world. So that's a very shh kind of project right now. We haven't really talked to a lot of people about it. So we hope you'll keep up with that. Definitely give us your feedback on other games you would like to see us produce. When we started Queenship, it started with Open Spaces as a prototype that we made for a Ludum Dare game jam. So, if you're not familiar, a game jam is where a bunch of people get together and in a set amount of time, usually a weekend. Excuse me, sorry. You build a working model of a game. So Open Spaces was what we produced, and we got such incredible feedback from it that we decided that we should keep working on it. And while we were continuing its development, we talked about building a company based around making games about mental health. So that's what we're doing. We actually just celebrated our 1-year anniversary as a company, which we're pretty proud of. Most companies shut their doors within the first year, but we're still making games. So I guess we're doing something right. Calls or like the chief source of misery is that your nose just runs like a fountain 24/7. Fucking gross, isn't it? Yeah, so this is the adorable thing I was talking about. You meet this little plant friend, and you run into him a couple of times. He follows you around, but you try to approach him. He's just like, oh gosh, I gotta hide! You're terrifying, even though I'm here to help you. Very weird, but super adorable. To drop an apple. Say, does it mean? I don't know for sure if that's a male or female plant. I feel like these little cubist apples are just so cute. Hey, little guy. It's so cute, isn't it? Come,
jump into the stump with me. Okay. As I mentioned earlier, one of the things I like best is the idea that always have tools to move forward inside of yourself. And I think that's really what this is all about. But sometimes you need guidance too. Like, the first time I saw my little plant friend here, I thought about my therapist. Because, you know, your plant friend is guiding you through difficult terrain. You do have to do a lot of the work yourself. It's hard. It's incredibly hard. But nothing worth doing is easy, right? I did get a dinner. Recovery is hard work, and it's mostly done alone. Not completely. To recover from anything, you need a lot of support. Not just from, you know, a mental health professional, friends, your family, your community. But a lot of the work is done in private. Trauma is sort of a difficult topic to discuss because it means so many different things for different people. Like, for some people, trauma has been, as loath as I am to say it, a transformative force in a positive way. Some people have been able to process their trauma in a way that adds to their sense of self, and their sense of personal power, rather than detracting from it. Some people, it might not even register as trauma, and they will go through life carrying a burden that they don't even know is one. And for some people, it becomes a burden so heavy that they never recover. I think it's why games like this are so important. Games are important because they reflect the human experience. I don't remember how I did this. Oh yeah, your little friend is perfectly okay. Spoiler alert, you will see it again. Think so far? What kind of feelings do you get from the game? I have a lot of feelings. I think I've made that very clear by now. It's okay, there will not be a quiz.
Hello.
Undisclosed reason, I think blue was the hardest color to play through, which is a little ironic because, see, here's your plant friend again. Blue's my favorite color, but... it was difficult. Alright, off we go. Durability. We'll jump and jump again. Sometimes stretching. When you encounter those red birds, you jump, and then when your feet are kind of simultaneous with them, you jump again and it launches you a great distance. Self-explanatory, Zephyr. Could you, elaborate on that a little bit? Just kind of the journey that she's on. Sorry, I totally misread that. Yeah, no, that is exactly the point. Is a little bit anxiety. It's very noisy. So. It's a little bit difficult to get through the terms of just game mechanics. obviously not like this. We're probably gonna wrap up. Maybe we'll try to get to the end of this section. But feel free to drop questions, comments, etc. Complaints, hope not. in the chat. And I will answer. Yeah, there's no way to lose the game. You can always go back and retrace your steps and try again. You can't back yourself into a corner. Sometimes it just takes a little while to figure out. that I mentioned, our Indiegogo campaign, I'm dropping a link in here. So feel free to share it around. Even if you can't pledge, that's totally okay. Spreading the word helps a ton. And if you haven't seen, if you haven't seen Open Spaces yet, you can grab it right here. And if you do play ahead, absolutely let us know what you think. Hopefully you find it a good and informative experience, even if you don't have either of the disorders depicted. We've had a number of people tell us that they had a better idea of how to help people they knew, constructively support them with their wellness and recovery with anxiety and agoraphobia. So if it helps you or helps you support someone you care about, definitely let us know. Thanks for joining me tonight. It's been really great to have you guys. We'll be back in a couple of weeks. The inestimable Mohua will be streaming next time. So we hope to see you soon. Thanks, guys.